Now, I have written a question on the blackboard. Cos inverse 4 by 5 plus cos inverse 12 by 13 is equal to cos inverse 33 by 65. Now, this question, we can easily adjust this question according to this property. And this question was in 2010 board exams also. Okay. So, now, what we are going to do, we are just going to insert the values of x and y there in the question. Okay. So, this property is the easiest property among all the properties. We have to do nothing without calculation, without learning the formulas, everything we can do it in a very simple way. In what we did in the last property, it was given here, suppose we were having sine inverse 4 by 5. So, what we did for that? For that, first of all, we find it cos. Okay. So, it was suppose this is x, this is suppose is equal to x, then what we write? Sine x is equal to 4 by 5. Then we find it cos x. Then we find it similarly for sine y, cos y. Then we put this in a formula. The formula which we used was sine a plus b is equal to sine a sine b, sine a cos b, sorry, cos a sine b. So, this was the formula which we used yesterday in our property. Okay. But now, how easy it is for this part. Now, what we are going to do, you just have to mention the property. And mind one thing, while doing such an easy question, don't go directly for it. Okay, just give some reasons for it. Now, for the solution part, what we can write it? We can write it cos inverse 4 by 5 plus cos inverse 12 by 13, and this is what? This is left hand side. Okay, left hand side is this part. Now, if we are comparing, with cos inverse x plus cos inverse y, means this one we are comparing with cos inverse x plus cos inverse y. So, what x is? We get x is equal to 4 by 5 and y is equal to, y is what? 12 by 13. So, this means that this value we can directly insert in our property. Okay. So, you can highlight the property which you are using. You can write it cos inverse x plus cos inverse y is equal to cos inverse xy minus square root of 1 minus x square times square root of 1 minus y square. So, it means now x and y easily we can insert for the that side. So, left hand side is this one. And now, what is right hand side? Right hand side, in the question it is cos inverse 33 by 65. So, it is 33 by, sorry, it is cos inverse 33 by 65. Cos inverse 33 by 65. Now, using this property, can we get this term? Let's check it. Okay. So, now we are having cos inverse x into y, x is what? 4 by 5 times 12 by 13 minus square root of 1 minus 4 by 5 whole square times 1 minus 12 by 13 whole square. Now, only this is the calculation part where we should be very much careful for while solving these calculations. So, now to this part we can write a cos inverse 4 upon 5 times 12 upon 13 becomes what? 48 upon 65 minus. Now, 1 minus 4 upon 5, either you can solve here also or you can solve on the rough side also. So, let's solve on the rough side. It is 1 minus, now it becomes 16 upon 25 and this becomes 25 minus 16 upon 25 and this is equal to 9 upon 25. Similarly, this part, second, 1 minus 144 upon 169, okay, square of 12, 144, square of 13, 169, okay. So, this becomes 169 minus 144 upon 169 and this becomes 5 upon 169. So what we are getting here now, after writing this part, let it be here only, cos inverse now 48 upon 65 minus square root of 9 by 25 times square root of 25 by 169. This becomes cos inverse 48 upon 65 minus 3 upon 5 times 5 upon 13. So further, 5 and 5 can be cancelled. We are left with cos inverse 48 by 65 minus 3 by 13. And after solving, what you are getting after taking the LCM, you are getting 33 upon 65. So this is proved. Hence proved. What we have proved? Left hand side is equal to right hand side for this whole question. So what I have done here, number one, I have shown the property here. This I have highlighted. Second thing, I have used that I am comparing this part. And third thing, I am showing rough work on the same sheet. Okay, so nicely you can attempt this question like this.